Good morning, students. When we met last time, we learnt about nouns and different forms of nouns and their uses. Today we are going to learn something more about noun, and particularly a part of a word which is connected with noun. Please look at the board. Karan is a student. He bought a laptop. The student eats an egg daily. Generally, in a sentence, we have three parts: subject, verb, and object. Subject, in the place of subject and object, we find nouns or pronouns. You first look at the sentence. Karan is a noun, it's a proper noun. Student is a noun, it's a common noun. And the second sentence, you have pronoun in the subject place. In the object place, we have a common noun. In third sentence, we have a common noun in the subject place, and again common noun in the object place. Now, student is a countable noun. It is preceded by a word a. In the second sentence, laptop is a countable noun. It is preceded by a. Here, the student is preceded by the. And here, in the object place, we have an egg. It is preceded by an. These words, a, an, the, are articles. Now, look at this. Now, look at the slide. See and speak out slide. Okay, this is a bird. Here is an egg. The bird is blue, but the egg is brown. A, an, and the are three words known as articles. What is an article? An article acts like an adjective. Like adjectives, articles modify nouns. Now read some sentences given here. There is a book on the chair. He eats an apple a day. Karan is a good boy. The principal is in the chamber. Now you see the underlined words. Book, chair, apple, day, boy, principal, chamber are nouns. A and the, like adjectives, modify them. Generally, articles are also known as demonstrative adjectives. There are two types of article. See the chart. Articles, indefinite and definite. Under indefinite, we have a or an. Under definite, we have the. A or an, the weakened form of one. The is the weakened form of that. A an is used to modify non-specific, non-particular nouns. This is used to refer to specific. The is used to refer to specific or a particular nouns. Example, I want to talk to a teacher. That means any teacher rather than a specific teacher. Read the second sentence. I want to talk to the teacher. That means the teacher means a particular teacher. Now, if you want to use properly a or an, first of all, we shall learn about the letters and the sounds in English language. There are 26 letters in English alphabet, of which 5 are vowels, A, E, I, O, U, and 21 are consonants, B, C, D, F, G, H, up to Z. But English has 44 sounds, 20 are vowel sounds and 24 are consonantal sounds. Now, the chart shows 20 sounds of vowel sounds in English. Now, let's see the second chart. Here, the chart displays the sounds of consonants. These are 24. Thus, the use of a or an depends on the sound the word begins with. A is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonantal sound. A boy. The first sound of the boy is ba. A man. Ma. A chair. Cha. A ear. Ya sound. A yard. A cat. You find here ka. A fan. Fa. A table. Ta. A woman. Wa. In all these words, the first sound is consonant. So, we have used A. A is also used before a word with vowel symbol but with a consonant sound. For example, university. The first sound, actually the first letter is vowel, but the sound is consonant. So a university. Similarly, a union, a eucalyptus tree, a European, a one-man committee. And takes the place of A when the word begins with a vowel sound or silent H. Now look at the words here given. An apple, an elephant, an eagle, an ink pot, an orange, an umbrella. In all these words, the first sound of the words is vowel. So we have used an instead of a. The following five words, remember the following five words with the silent H take an hour, an honor, an honest man, an heir, an heirloom. In all these five words, the beginning letter is H, but it is not pronounced. So we have used an. Let's test ourselves. Okay, insert A or an in the following words. African, ulcer, yellow dot, flower, ideology, universal fact, X-ray plant, unique feature, MA degree, young man, honorable man, you, historical novel, aunt, hostel, old man, upstart, umbrella, BA degree, often, European, Indian, ugly boy, aircraft, SIF police, actor, Hindu cult. Now let's check our answers. Here African, it is preceded by an because of vowel sound. A young man, a BA degree, an ulcer, an honorable man, an orphan, a yellow dot, an who, a European, a flower, a historical novel, an Indian, an ideology, an aunt, an ugly boy, an universal fact. I'm sorry, here you have to use A instead of an, it is a mistake. A hostel, an aircraft, an X-ray plant, an old man, an SIF police, a unique fact, an abstract, an actor, an MA degree, an umbrella. Here again you have to use A instead of an, a Hindu cult, because H is pronounced here. Now look at the word MA degree and BA degree. MA, when you find the word, it begins with M, but when you pronounce it, the sound, beginning sound is E, A. So we have to use vowel, we have to use an because it, there is a vowel sound in it. But when you come to BA, the first sound is a ba, so you have to use A. Now uses of indefinite article, where to use and where not to use, we have to be very careful in using A or an. As an introducing word, the indefinite article is used before a singular count noun mentioned for the first time. Now look at the sentence, first sentence. I saw a woman with a baby. Yesterday I read an interesting story. Bring me a glass of water. He helped an old woman cross the road this morning. Here the speaker of these sentences are might be meeting the persons referred in the sentences for the first time. I saw a woman with a baby, and he is not familiar with the woman or the baby. So there is A in the sentence. Now another point, A or an is used with a singular noun to make it represent all class. A cow is a domestic animal. When you use A before a singular noun, it represents all class. All cows are domestic animals. It means all cows are domestic animals. A living dog is stronger than a dead lion. An eel lives in the water. That means all eels live in the water. A rose is a beautiful flower. All roses are beautiful flowers. A or an used before certain numerical expressions. Now let's see. A dozen, half a dozen, a gross, a score, a hundred, a thousand, a million. Let's read a sentence here. He eats half a dozen bananas daily. And in the phrases like a lot of, a great deal of, a great many of, now you have to use a in the phrases like a lot of, a great deal of, a great many of. Why is missing here? A lot of people gathered in the hall. A or an is used in the sense of every. He gets a salary of ₹10,000 a month. That means every month. She walks 10 kilometers an hour. Every hour she walks 10 kilometers. I spend $1,000 a week on transport. Every week I spend 1,000 rupees towards my transportation. Also, A or an is used in the exclamations. What a nice day. What a pretty girl. Such a pity. What a fine painting. Now, we have the habit of using the without knowing its value in many of sentences we utter. So, it is imperative on our part to learn where not to use the. Let's see. The is used before a noun which has been introduced already and made definite. In the previous slides, I showed a sentence like I saw a woman with a baby. For the first time, if I am meeting something, I will be using indefinite article. If it is made definite by repetition, you have to use the. Now, let's see examples here. There lived a king in India. The king had a son and a daughter. The son was foolish, but the daughter was clever. Why the in the second, okay, following sentences? Because in the first two sentences, for the first time son and daughter are mentioned, so they are preceded by a, but the repetition is occur in the following sentences, so we have to use the. I saw an orphan in the market. Now repetition, the orphan was singing a song melodiously. She has a car and an old scooter. The car is blue and the scooter is red. You have seen the difference. First time when you mention a car, okay, you have to say a car, old scooter, an old scooter. But repetition occurs, so you have to use the. The is used before a noun referring to a thing which is clear from the context. Open the window. Open the window means the window which of the room in which you might be sitting. Mother is in the kitchen, mother of the speaker, okay, or the kitchen where mother works. I am going to the library of your college. Please pass the sugar on the table. Someone is standing at the gate of your house or the college. I am in the studio where I am teaching you now. The is placed before an uncount noun when it is followed by a definite phrase or clause. Look at the sentences. The pen that you gave me is very nice. Now let's break the sentence. The pen is very nice, but the pen is, okay, here specified or made definite by the use of clause that you gave me. That is why we use the before pen. The man who is sitting there is a great painter. I like the car which I drove yesterday. Bring the book that is on the table. Here, in all these sentences, the nouns are made specific by the clauses that are following. So, we have to use the before them. These also used for generalization, for a whole class or species. Now, we have learnt it in the use of a and an. When you use a or an before a common noun, it represents whole class. Similarly, if you use the before a common noun, countable common noun, it also represents whole class. The cow gives milk. That means all cows give milk. The dictionary is a useful book. All the dictionaries are useful. The rose is a beautiful flower. That means all roses are beautiful flowers. But you must be careful in using man and woman when they are used in generic sense or in general sense or with the widest meaning, they do not take any article. Look at the examples. Man is mortal. You should not say a man or the man. Woman is man's mate. Let's test ourselves. There is an exercise for you. Read the sentences and fill in the blanks. This is a dash important question. I shall be back in dash hour. Smith is dash English name. My brother is dash engineer. He is dash union leader. I failed to pay dash installment. My brother bought dash radio. I bought dash horse, dash ogs, and dash buffalo. Check your answers. This is an important question. Why? And because the word following begins with a vowel sound. I shall be back in an hour. H-O-U-R. H is not pronounced, so we have to use an here. Smith is an English name. My brother is an engineer. He is a union leader. Union, the first sound is ya, though it is a vowel. I failed to pay an installment. My brother bought a radio. I bought a horse, an ox, and a buffalo. Now, there is another test for you. Just read the incomplete paragraph and try to complete by using a or an. Once there was a dash mouse. What did we learn? When we use something for the first time, you have to use indefinite article. When it is repeated, you have to use the. Now see, once there was a dash mouse. So, I hope you got the answer for this. Shall we see the answers? Fill in the blanks with another exercise. Most of you might have answered some of the items, but now check yourself with the answers given here. Once there was a mouse. The mouse was always in anxiety because, like other mice, it was afraid of a cat. A magician took pity on the mouse and turned it into a cat. Now, the cat was afraid of dogs. So, the magician turned it into a dog. Then, the dog began to fear tigers. Now, the magician turned the dog into a tiger. The tiger began to fear the hunters in the forest. Then, the magician said, "Be a mouse again. You are no better than the mouse at heart." Now, you see, this. Okay, whenever a word is repeated, "the" is used. Now, come to another point. "The" is used before adjectives or participles to turn them into plural nouns. The poor is an adjective. When it is preceded by the, it means poor people. Noun is implied here. The rich means the rich people. The disadvantaged, the weak, the dying, the strong. In all these cases, noun is missing, but it is implied. Okay, you need not use noun. Simply, you can use the and adjective to mean, to suggest the plural sense of it. Now, look at the sentences, some examples. The rich should show pity on the poor. Helen Keller was interested in the blind. In the blind means in the blind people. The injured were taken to hospital means the injured persons were taken to hospital. These used before ordinals. The first, the second, the third, the tenth, the hundredth. These ordinals means the words which show the order of the things that occur in the sentences or in situation. Instead of saying one, we say first, that shows the order. The first, the second. Now, see some examples. The 7th of January, the 21st of July, He arrived in the city on the 3rd of June. She was the first to come and the last to go. In all these sentences, ordinals are used. When ordinals are used, they should be preceded by definite article the. We have to use the before superlatives. You know the superlative, generally, by adding es to the base form of the adjective, we find the superlative word. The tallest boy, the cleverest girl, the bravest person, the best book, the most important question. In all these words, there is a superlative word. So, when there is a superlative word, you have to be careful in using the. And now look at the examples here. Teja is the strongest boy in the class. He wants the best education for his son. Gopal is one of the worst persons. But there is an exception. When you use most, most can also be preceded by an indefinite article. For example, a most important book is also possible. When most means nearly all, there is another word in English, least. Least means the smallest quantity, no article is used. Again, most and least are two exceptions in English. When most means nearly all, when least means smallest quantity, you should not use any article before them. Most people like junk food. He works least and is paid most. These used before the names of peoples, particularly nations. Peoples means nations, and adjectives formed from proper nouns. This is a very important point. When we are referring to nations or using adjectives formed from proper nouns, these should be used. For example, English, English is a proper noun, but here it is used an adjective because the language is a noun here. The English language, the French, the Chinese, the Spanish, the Hindu, the Hindus, the Buddhists, and the Hindus and the Buddhists refer to people. But don't use the before the expressions like Englishmen, Frenchmen, Spaniards, Irishmen. These words refer to nationality. These used in the sentences showing proportion. Very interesting use. Most of us learn it to express proportion whenever we are comparing, when two things grow proportionately, we have to use the. The older he grew, the wiser he became. The higher you go, the cooler you feel. The more you eat, the fatter you become. The more one has, the more one wants. In all these sentences, the use of the is in the sense of adverb. It acts like an adverb in these sentences. These used before a noun denoting a unique object, that means which is only one of its kind. The sun, the moon, the stars, the heavens, the sky, the earth, the poles, the horizon. But there are some exceptions to it. Hell, heaven, paradise, purgatory, space, nature generally do not take the. Don't use the before these words. The is used before names of countries like the USA, the UK, the UAE. It is also used before holy books or mythological texts, the Gita, that is the Bhagavad Gita, the Bible, the Quran, the Mahabharata, the Ramayana. It is also used before mountain ranges, the Himalayas, the Alps, the Vindhyas. These also used before the names of seas and oceans, the Pacific Ocean, the Bay of Bengal, the Indian Ocean, the Red Sea. It is also used before the names of rivers, the Godavari, the Nile, the Thames, the Krishna, the Ganges. These also used before gulfs, straits, and canals. The Persian Gulf, the Straits of Gibraltar, the Suez Canal, the English Channel. These also used before groups of islands, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the West Indies. But there are some exceptions to this rule. Names of single mountains and islands do not take the Everest or Mount Everest, Mount Blanc, Cyprus, Malta. These words, when you use in your sentences, don't use the before them. Don't say the Everest. Say only Everest. The is used before names of ships and trains. The Titanic, it is the name of a ship. The Vikramaditya, name of a ship. The GT Express, name of a train. The Chennai Express, you are familiar with this. So, whenever you use name of a train or ship, okay, mind using the before them. Before the names of the newspapers. So, the comes before the names of newspapers. Generally, we are familiar with the newspaper Hindu. The Hindu, the Times of India, the New York Times, the Hans India. But take care when the title is already has the, don't use another the before it. Now, let us point another important example or exception. Magazines and periodicals do not take the. Time, Newsweek, India Today, Sun, Filmfare. These are the names of, these are the titles of magazines or periodicals. They are used without the, don't use any article before them. These used before the names of hotels or restaurants, cinemas and theatres. The Malabar Hotel, the Grand Hotel, the IMAX, the Abhilash, the Sapphire, the Globe, it is the name of theatre. The Palace, the Odeon. Names of public institutions, associations also are preceded by the British Museum, the Secretariat, the United Nations. Names of peoples or families, this already I mentioned in the previous slide, the English, the French, the Nehrus, the Tatas, the Birlas, the Stuarts. The Tatas, the Birlas, the Nehrus, when the famous families, when they are, okay, these used to refer to the plural of, okay, the plurality of their family, and you can use to mean entire family members. Now, let us see, these used before the names of important buildings or monuments. The Taj Mahal, the Charminar, the White House, the Eiffel Tower, the Red Fort. I hope you recognize the pictures here. The first one is the Red Fort. When you say Red Fort, the Red Fort. In the middle, you have the White House, Eiffel Tower, the Eiffel Tower. The indefinite article or a or an. The definite article means that the is used before a proper noun. To make it a common noun. This is very important usage in English language. He is a Valmiki. That means he is not real Valmiki, but he has the qualities of the great poet Valmiki. That means an inspired poet. Kalidasa is the Shakespeare of India. That means Kalidasa has the traits of Shakespeare or the qualities, the characteristics of Shakespeare. Of England. Delhi is the Paris of India. That means whatever you find in Paris could also be found in Delhi. So, when you make some comparisons regarding the characteristics, you have to use the before proper noun. Generally, proper nouns do not take articles. We will be coming to that. KCR is a Gandhi of Telangana. You can also use A. So, here he has the potentiality of Gandhi and by which he got Telangana for us. He is a second Newton. He has the characteristics of Newton, great scientist. Karan is the Bhima of our family. He is as strong as Bhima. These used before a common noun to give it a sense of an abstract noun. I hope you know the meaning of any of the previous class. When I met last year, I discussed what actually abstract noun is. An abstract noun is a name of a thing which we cannot see and touch. So when you use the before a common noun, you will have the abstract idea. He played the fool, means he behaved like a foolish, like a foolish man. He has the foolish qualities in him. He felt the patriot in his heart. That means the patriotic spirit. At last, the mother in her was aroused. The motherly feeling came out. These used before the names of musical instruments. I hope you know the names of some instruments. The piano, the guitar, the clarinet, the flute, the trumpet, the violin, the harp. He plays on the flute. So you have to use the before musical instruments. These used before the names of parts of the body in place of possessive. Make him stand by the ear. That means make him stand by his ear. Instead of using possessive pronoun, you can substitute it with definite article the ear. He struck me on the head. That means on my head. He led me into his house by the hand, by taking my hand. These used before a proper noun, used as an adjective. The great Caesar, the immortal Shakespeare. These also used before the titles or awards. The Bharat Ratna, the Padma Bhushan, the Padma Shri, the Nobel Prize. So you have to be careful in using article before it. You have to use the before them. These used before scientific inventions, the radio, the television, the computer. Now, this is a very important point. When two connected nouns refer to the same person or thing, these used before the first noun. Let's read the sentence. Mr. Rao is the chairman and managing director of the company. Here two nouns, chairman and managing director, are connected by and, but they are referring to the same person, Mr. Rao. So, one the is enough before the first noun, but this is very, very important. But when they refer to two different persons or things, the is used before two nouns. Now, look at the sentence. The producer and the director were present at the function. Here, producer and director are two different persons. So, you have to use the before them. Now, we should also be very careful where articles are not used. A or an is not used before plural nouns or uncountable nouns. However, to refer to a specific quantity or item of its kind, the following expression is used. A dash of plus uncountable noun. Similarly, T is uncountable, but if you want to count it, specify its a quantity, you can take the help of cup, a cup of tea, a glass of water, a piece of news, a loaf of bread, a good deal of progress, a bar of chocolate, a word of advice, a grain of sugar, an item of luggage. In all these cases, you cannot say teas or waters or newses, breads. So, they are uncountable. So, in order to specify their quantity, you can take the help of some words preceded by indefinite article. Articles are not used before proper nouns. Tagore was a truly great poet. Gandhi is the father of the nation. Delhi is the capital of India. Everest is the highest peak in the world. But there are some exceptions to this rule. The Congo, the Sudan, the Ukraine, the Crimea, the Punjab, the Deccan, the Carnatic. In India, we have a name of the state Punjab. It is preceded by the because it means Punjab means five rivers. It is a descriptive noun, so you have to use the before it. Article is not used before abstract nouns. Wisdom, honesty, common sense, patience and perseverance, beauty. In all these, beauty or truth, all these are abstract nouns. There is no article used before them. But when it is particularized, you have to use article. The joy in his heart is immeasurable. You are talking about the joy of a particular person. The greatness in him is that he has no pride. And article is also not used before material nouns. You see the examples: gold, iron, brick and stone, silver, wood. In all these sentences, I am just referring to the words, abstract, okay, material nouns. But when they are specified, we can use: the gold of India is pure. The gold of India is pure. The wood used for the house was imported. When you specify them, you can use article before them. Before a common noun used in its widest sense: man is mortal. All men are mortal. Animals have undeveloped brain. Science tries to discover the laws of nature. Books are our best companions. Life is a precious gift. Air is necessary to life. Poetry is emotion recollected in tranquility. All these underlined words or nouns refer to or mean the general sense. So when they are used to mean general sense or general idea, present general idea, don't use article before them. Article is not used with feast days or months or days of the week: Christmas, Independence Day, Republic Day, UN Day, New Year's Day, College Day, June, Monday. When you have these words in your sentences, don't use any article before them. Similarly, now let's read the sentence. We celebrated College Day last week. You cannot say the College Day. Article is dropped in the following phrases: be in bed, be in church, be school, be in school, be in college, be in hospital, go to bed, go to church. No article used before, okay, any one of these expressions. Now look at some examples and the pictures. The baby is in bed. Don't say the baby is in the bed. The boy is in the hospital. Don't say the boy is in the hospital. The boy is in hospital. The kids are in church. Don't use any article before the names of meals: breakfast, lunch, tea, dinner, supper. Okay, but when you specify it, the breakfast I had in the morning is very tasty. Now, in the phrases that, okay, suggest the the mode of transport: go by air, go by boat, go by car, go by plane, bus, train, ship. Don't use any article before the go by a car. It is a wrong sentence. Go by an aeroplane. It's a wrong expression. So, without an article, you can use these expressions. Article is not used in the following phrases: at dawn, at sunrise, at sunset, at noon, at night. I am coming to the last: by name, on sale, on foot, in turn. Now let's see an example. He sent a word that he got a job. He sent a word that he got a job. What is wrong with the sentence? Here A is not required. He sent word that he got a job. That's the answer. Don't take an offense so easily. What is the error in the sentence? An offense is a wrong expression. See the answer. Don't take offense so easily. Before titles used in opposition to proper noun. Apposition means, so you look at the word with the spelling A, it begins with A. That is used as a complement which completes the sense of the word. Solomon, son of David, was the wisest monarch. He was elected chairman. Generally we use, he was elected a chairman or the chairman. That is the wrong expression. Don't use articles when nouns are used in opposition. Article is not used before the names of diseases: typhoid, cholera, jaundice, malaria, flu. But exceptions to this: a cold, a cough, a cancer, a fever, a headache. You can use A before them. He is suffering from a cold. And similarly, articles are not used before the names of colors. The color of my car is the green. That is the wrong expression. The color of my car is green. These are not used before titles coming before proper nouns. Look at some examples: King George VI, Lord Swaraj Pal, Professor Sharma, Saint Paul. don't use the or a before them. And you can also not supposed to use article before the names of streets. There are many shops in Connaught Place. Chandni Chowk is a beautiful place in Delhi. Sardar Patel Road is always busy with the traffic. Institutions named after persons or places do not take the. Kakatiya University, you cannot say the Kakatiya University. Usmania University, St. Paul's Cathedral, St. Peter's Basilica. But these used when the construction includes of, when there is a construction like of, you can use the University of Madras, the University of Kerala. No article is used before the names of games, volleyball, basketball, cricket, chess. Now read the sentence, he plays the caroms. This is a mistake, he plays caroms. And before the names of food grains, rice, wheat, maize, jaw, red gram, black gram, no article is required here. The people in Telangana eat the rice. That is a mistake. You have to say eat rice. I hope you have understood some important points. If you have any queries, you can directly ask me regarding the use of articles. If you don't have any query, let's proceed with the last slide. These not used when the following are used for their primary purpose. This is very important. School, college, temple, church, hospital, prison, university. When these words are used for their primary purpose, generally what is the primary purpose of college? To study. When you are going to college to study, no article is required. Now you see the examples. When I leave school, I go to college. She goes to temple every Friday. Raju is a doctor. He goes to hospital every day. But see the difference. Venu goes to the school to meet the principal. Here Venu is not a student. He is going to particular school to meet the principal, not to study. So we can use the there. But when they are used for primary purpose, articles are not required. Again, I want to have some queries from you. If you have any query, any doubt regarding the use of articles, you can straight away ask me, I'll try to answer your problems. Thank you very much. Now we will be meeting in another class, you know, discussing some more important points. Are there any queries?